Hello, me dearios. Well, tonight I shall have great pleasure, but first of all... I'd like to sing you a few songs. So loosen your grussets, traddle your thrums, let your bossocks down, and away we go. Now I should like to burst forth with a traditional Lincolnshire air. 'Tis the song of the Bogle Clencher, and goes after this fashion. When I was a clencher's bogle man in famous Lincoln town, I often clenched my bogling fork for less than half a crown. And I would joggle and nirk my boys, as I shall quickly tell. Oh, 'tis mighty light on a shiny night, and a foggy night as well. Oh, once I took my moolies and set them in a snare. 'Twas then I spied a scroper's man a wordle in a hare. But I was not afeard, my boys, of that there is no doubt. Oh, 'tis mighty light on a shiny night when the coppers aren't about. Although I'm over 80 now, my boggles still I clench. And I will flutter my artifacts at any passing wench. I've tickled many a scribbling nut as on my way I go. Oh, 'tis mighty light on a shiny night at 1 and 9 a throw. Thank you very much. Well, I've been dipping in me old gander bag, and I've come up with a very tender and furtive madrigal, which has been passed down from father to son until the handle dropped off. It is an old Sussex courting song and tells the story of a young swain who stands beneath his loved one's bearer. He's a very, very small swain, but then she's got a very low bearer. It's the prevailing winds, you see. Anyway, he stands there in the full moonlight, a plighting his troth. It's best to plight it where you can see it. Otherwise, you're liable to make a dog's breakfast of the old rigmarole. So there he is, a plighting his troth. The troth, by the way, is a small furry creature with fins. It's a cross between a trout and a sloth or sloth. And it's a curious match. I often wonder what they saw in each other in the first place. Though I suppose the sloth hanging upside down tends to have a different slant on things. Anyway, nowadays, people do say that they're extinct, but I believe they're hanging about somewhere and that they'll come round when they're hungry. So anyway, this lover is under this tree singing to his light o' love, and he tells her of his desires as follows. Will you still love me, Mary, oh, when my grussets be bended low? When my orbs grow dim and my pubes grow white? And my cord wangle makes an ugly sight. And my grussets be bended low. My grussets be bended low. And she sings back to him. Ask me if I'll love you, oh, though your grassets be bended low, though your orbs be dim and your pubes be white, and your cord wangle makes an ugly sight, if I feel the way I do tonight, my answer will still be no. Now, in a more light-hearted vein, a pewter woggler's banglin' song. After our day in the grunge foundry, hammering their artifacts, the jolly grunge men repair to the local hostelry or fumble shop. And charge their thunder jugs with the foaming nut brown myths. And then they link nadgers and let forth this stirring refrain as follows. Come, fellows, raise your fumble jugs until your cringe is plunging. Come, raise aloft your nut-brown grot, for soon we'll all be munging. For tonight I'll drain the posset dry, every man shall do the same as I. If he don't, I'll wordle in his eye. Tomorrow we'll be grunging. Whoa.